Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we have to discuss about C program to print the reverse of a given number. Suppose I am taking the number 1234. This is the given number. So to print the reverse of a given number, what is the number we are getting? 4321. Next, I am taking another number 7342. So after reversing the given number, then what we are getting? 2437. So now, what is the logic we have to follow to print the reverse of a given number? Okay. So first, I am declaring three variables n. N contains the given number. Next one, REV is equal to 0. So after reversing the given number N, the result is stored in the variable called REV. Initially, REV value is equal to 0. Why we are initializing this REV value? Initially, REV value contains some garbage value. So to remove that garbage value, first we have to initialize REV value, and another variable R I am taking. So these are the three variables that we are declared before using in the program. Now, what is the logic we have to follow? So I am taking a while loop, while n greater than 0, brace begin. First, I am taking R. R is equal to n modulus operator 10. Next, REV is equal to REV into 10 plus R. Next, n is equal to n by 10. So these are the three statements in the body of the while loop. After while loop, we have to print the reverse of a given number is, percentage D slash n double quotes n. The result is stored in the variable called REV. So this is the logic of the this program. Now, how we are getting the 4321 for the 1234. Okay, first I am taking this step. Initially, n value is equal to 1234. Okay, n value is equal to 1234. So I am here writing step 1. Step 1. First, why n greater than 0? What is the n value? 1234. 1234 greater than 0. Condition true. If the condition is true, then these three statements are executed that are in the body of the while loop. First one is R is equal to n modulus operator 10. N value is 1234 modulus operator 10. We are already know that 1234 modulus operator 10 means it returns the remainder value. 123 is 1230. So what is the remainder value? This is the 4. So this 4 becomes here. Okay. Remainder value it returns. Modulus operator returns the remainder value. So remainder value 4 we are getting. Next one, REV is equal to REV into 10. Initially, REV value 0. So 0 into 10 plus R. R value, in this step, what we are getting the R value? 4. This one. So 0 plus 4 is equal to 4. Next one. N is equal to n by 10. So 1234 divided by 10. 1234 divided by 10 means it returns the quotient value. So this is the quotient value, this is the remainder value. This step returns the remainder value, this step returns the quotient value. Okay, so quotient value what we are getting, that is 123. Okay, so after executing the three statements within the body of the while loop, what we are the values we are getting? R value is 4, REV value is 4, N value is 123. Now again control goes to the while loop condition. Okay, so this is the second iteration. What is the N value we are getting from the previous step, that is 123. Now again we are checking while N greater than 0. N is nothing but now what is the previous step result. In the previous step N value is 123. So now I am taking N value is equal to 123. Now while N greater than 0, that means 123 greater than 0. So condition true. If the condition is true, the control goes to the body of the while loop and execute these three statements. First one, R is equal to N modulus operator 10. In this step, N value is 123. 123 modulus operator 10. So here I am taking 123 divided with 10. 10 twelves, 123 remainder. Okay, this value I am taking. Next one, REV is equal to REV into 10 plus R. In the previous step, what is the REV value we are getting? That is 4. Now, 4 into that value I am taking here plus R value. What is the R value we are getting here? 3. Okay. So that is 4 into 10, 40, 40 plus 3, that is 43. So in the previous step, REV value we are getting is 4. Okay, so REV is equal to REV into 10. So here this REV value can be taken from the previous step, that is 4, 4 into 10 plus R. R value can be taken here. Okay, 3. 4 into 10 plus 3 is equal to 43. So here R value can be taken from this step, REV value can be taken from the previous step. In the previous step, REV value is 4. Okay, so 4 into 10, that is 40, plus R value can be taken from this step, 3, that is equal to 43. Next one, N is equal to N by 10, so 123 divided by 10. Here I am taking the quotient value. What is the quotient value we are taking? 12. So I am taking this 12. So after executing the second step, second iteration, what are the values we are getting? R value is equal to 3, REV value is equal to 43, and N value is equal to 12. Okay. So now again the control goes to the while condition. Okay, while loop condition, that is the third one. So for this step, N value is 12 and REV value is equal to 43. So these two values can be taken from the previous step. Okay, here for this step, so REV value is equal to 4. So N value is 123, REV value is equal to 4. These two values can be taken from the previous iteration or previous step. Now, while N greater than 0, N value is 12. So 12 greater than 0, condition true. If the condition is true, the control goes to the body of the while loop. So these three statements are executed. R is equal to N modulus operator 10. What is N value here? 12. 12 modulus operator 10 is equal to, so 12 can be divided with 10, 10 ones, 10. So remainder value, this is the value it returns, that is 2. Next one, REV is equal to REV into 10. What is the REV value in the previous step? That is 43. So 43 into 10 plus R. 43 into 10. 10 plus R. R value can be taken from this step only. That is 2. So that is 4,343 into 12. That is 430. 430 plus 2. That is 432. Okay. Next one. N is equal to N by 10. 12 divided by 10. This value returns the quotient value. Quotient value is 1. Okay. So, after completing these three statements within the body of the while loop, R value is 2, RGB value 432, N value is equal to 1. Now, again the control goes to the while loop condition. So, for the now, it is the fourth iteration. So, RGB value is 432 and N value is equal to 1. These two values are forwarded to the next step. Okay. Now, while N greater than 0, N means 1, 1 greater than 0. So, condition true. If the condition is true, then what are the three steps we have executed? Okay. So, first one, R value. R is equal to N modulus operator 10. So, N value is 1. 1 modulus operator 10. So, what is the result we are? So, 1 I am taking. It divides with 10. 10, 0, 0, remainder 1. Okay. So, this remainder value can be written. Okay. Next one, RGB is equal to RGB into 10 plus R. In the previous step, what is the RGB value? 432. So, 432 into 10 plus R value. What is the R value we are getting? 1. So, then what is the value we are getting? 4321. Okay. Next, N is equal to N by 10. So, N by 10 means N value 1, 1 by 10. So, this value it returns. That is 0. Okay. So, after completing the fourth iteration, what is the values we are getting? R value 1, RGB value 4321, N value 0. Again, after executing these three statements, again the control goes to the while loop condition. Now, that is the fifth step. In the fifth step, what are the values that we have taken from the fourth step or fourth iteration? So, RGB value is equal to 4321. N value is equal to 0. Okay, these two values can be taken from the fourth iteration. Now, again we are checking the condition while 0 greater than 0. N value is 0. 0 greater than 0. That is false. Okay. So, whenever the condition is false, the control goes to the next statement after the while loop. While loop starts here and ends here. After the while loop, this is the statement is there. Printf, reverse of a given number is %d slash n double quotes n comma REV. So, now the reverse of a given number is, this statement is printed. Reverse of a given number. Finally, the statement is printed. Reverse of a given number is, what is the value that is stored in the variable REV? REV value is 4321. Okay. So, for the given number 1234, the reverse of a given number is 4321. We are already getting 4321. So, this is the logic we have to follow for getting the reverse of a given number. So, how many number of iterations? Iterations are there? Total 5 iterations are there. In 4 iterations are completely executing the statements within the body of the while loop. At the 5th iteration, the condition is false. The control goes to the next statement after the while loop. So, after the while loop, so the variable RGB stores the value is 4321. That value is printed. So, that value is the reverse of the given number 1234. Okay. Now, we can go for the implementation.
Now we have to see the implementation of C program to print the reverse of a given number. So first I am declaring n RGB is equal to 0 R. These three variables are integer variables. Now printf enter the n value. N value is read from the keyboard by using scanf function. After that, while n greater than 0, brace begin, R is equal to n modulus operator 10, REV is equal to REV into 10 plus R, n is equal to n by 10, while loop close. So printf, the reverse of the given number is %d slash n double quotes end comma REV. Now first we have to save the program. I am saving this program as reverse.c. Now we have to compile the program. For compiling the program, we have to use alt plus F9, alt F9 command. So we are getting 0 errors and 0 warnings. Now we are running the program. For running the program, we have to use control plus F9, control F9. So we are getting 0 errors, 0 warnings while compiling. After running the program, we are getting the output n value. Enter the n value, 1234 I am giving. So press alt F5. So the reverse of the given number is 4321. Now once again I am compiling the program. For second output, alt F, alt C for compiling the program. 0 errors, 0 warnings. Alt F9, alt plus F9 command is also used for compiling the program. So while compiling the program, we are getting 0 errors and 0 warnings. Run the program. Control plus F9, control F9. So enter the n value. Now I am giving 7342. Press alt F5 for seeing the output. The reverse of the given number is 2437. So this is the output of the given program. So thank you. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please click on the like button and please subscribe my channel name Divvela Srinivas Rao. Thank you. Thank you one and all.